welcome to the normal mathematical domain. Today we shall be looking at solutions to Unified Tertiary Matriculation Examination, which is Jamb 2018. In this video, we shall consider question 1, question 2, and question 3. Okay, we start. Question 1 says, solve the quadratic inequality x squared minus 5x plus 6 greater or equals to 0. Now below are the options. We now go into the solution, because mathematics is not all about guesswork, but you must solve to get the answers. Okay, solution. Now bring down the problem, which is x squared minus 5x plus 6 greater or equals to 0. According to the rule of quadratic equation, we're going to look for two numbers that when we multiply will give us plus 6. Then when we add, those numbers will give us minus 5. Of course, those numbers are minus 3 and minus 2. This is because minus 3 times minus 2 is 6, and minus 3 plus minus 2 is minus 5. So from here we can now have, it implies that x squared minus 3x minus 2x plus 6 is greater or equals to 0. Of course, you can see clearly that this minus 3x minus 2x is what gives us minus 5x. So what we did here was to simply split it so that we'll be able to group them in pairs. So grouping them, we can now have x squared minus 3x grouped together, then minus 2x and 6 grouped together. Of course, from the first grouping, if you look at it, what is common among both is x. So when you bring down x, we're now going to have what is going to be having x into bracket x minus 3. Then in the second bracket, what is common among them is 2. So when we bring out minus 2 there, what is left is x minus 3. So from here, we can now take the ones outside, group them together. I mean this x and minus 2. When we group them together, we now have, it implies that x minus 2. Then this x minus 3 and x minus 3 is common, so we'll now pick one of them. So we now have x minus 2 and x minus 3 greater or equals to 0. In mathematical concepts, when two products are multiplied and the answer is 0, it means either the first one is 0 or the second one is 0. So from this case, we are having bracket of x minus 2 multiplied by bracket of x minus 3 greater or equals to 0. So it means that either x minus 2 is greater or equals to 0, or x minus 3 is greater or equals to 0. So when we solve for x, of course, from x minus 2 greater or equals to 0, when minus 2 crosses the equality sign, it now becomes plus 2. Also, when minus 3 crosses this inequality sign, it now becomes 3. So from here, we can now have our answer that x is greater or equals to 2, or x is greater or equals to 3. Now, when you look at the options that were given, you can clearly see that the answer is B. Okay, you can still look through it again to get yourself clarified. So now consider the next one, which is question number 2. Number 2 question says, in the diagram above, PQ, which is a line, is parallel to line RS. What is the size of the angle marked X? So below are the options. A, 100 degrees. B, 80 degrees. C, 50 degrees. D, 30 degrees. There's nothing you can do about it. You cannot guess it. So we have to go into the solution. Okay, since line PQ and RS are parallel, so we are going to use the concept of alternate angles to be able to determine the unknown angle. Of course, the law of geometry says that alternate angles are always equal. Okay, so using the concept that alternate angles are equal in two parallel lines, so from this, we bring down the diagram again. Now, please look at this diagram very carefully. If you look at this x here that was given, you are going to see that this x, angle x, is alternate to this angle here. That's why we say that they are equal, because alternate angles are equal. So if this angle x is equal to this angle x here, and of course this is a straight line, and according to the law of geometry, angles on a straight line add up to what? 180 degrees. So now if this is x, then obviously this will be 180 minus x. Then also this angle here was given to be 50 degrees. Then if you look at the parallel line critically, you will discover that this angle 50 is parallel to this angle here. So obviously this one is 50 degrees. Then for us to find the angle x, this is now a triangle, and according to the law of geometry, say that the sum of angle in a triangle adds up to 180. So we are simply going to add the angles together, equate it to 180 degrees, so that we can now get the unknown x. Okay, so since the total angle in a triangle is 180 degrees, so it implies that the 180 degrees minus the x degrees plus the 50 degrees plus 30 degrees is equals to 180 degrees, as we said earlier. So now collecting like terms, we now have this implies 180 plus 50 plus 30 gives us 260 degrees. Then minus x remains there and is still equated to 180 degrees. So now we're going to make x the subject of formula, because we're looking for x. So when the minus x crosses over, it will become plus x. Then when the 180 that was in the right hand side crosses over, it will become minus 180. So we now have something like this: 260 degrees minus 180 degrees equals to x degrees. When we do this simple arithmetic, we're now going to have 80 degrees equals to x degrees. This is because 260 degrees minus 180 degrees is 80 degrees. Therefore, our x is equals to 80 degrees. So from the option that we're given, you can now see that our answer is B. So we'll bring back the options so that you can see clearly. Okay, you can now look through it again to get more clarifications. But we'll now go into the next question, which is question number 3. And that's the last question for this particular video. The question says, find the gradient of a line which is perpendicular to a line with equation 3x plus 2y plus 1 equals to 1. And below are the options. Since we cannot guess, we still go back to solving it. Solution: we bring down the equation of the line, which is 3x plus 2y plus 1 equals to 1. Then we have to convert this into the standard equation of a straight line. Of course, the standard equation of a straight line is y equals to mx plus c, where m is the slope and the c is the intercept on the y-axis. So when we try to convert this equation, now we'll be trying to convert this equation into the standard form. So we're going to have something like this. So from 3x plus 2y plus 1 equals to 1, this implies that 3x plus 2y equals to 1 minus 1. Actually, we brought this one to cross over the equality sign and it became a minus number. So from here, this implies that 3x plus 2y equals to 0, because 1 minus 1 is 0. Then we are now to now make y the subject of formula, so that we can have it in the form y equals to mx plus c. So we're now going to take the 3x to cross over. So when we take it to cross over, we now have 2y equals to what? 0 minus 3x, and that gives us minus 3x. So then from here, we want to make y the subject of formula. We're going to simply divide both sides by 2. On doing this, we have y equals to minus 3 over 2x. Now we have gotten y equals to minus 3 over 2x. So on comparing with the standard equation of a straight line, which is y equals to mx plus c, you can see clearly that our slope, because from here, look at it, we have y here and this is also y. We have minus 3 over 2 here and this is m. So that means our slope m is this minus 3 over 2. Then we have x here and this is x. So there was nothing here. So it means our c, which is the intercept, is what? 0. Okay. because it was a perpendicular line. So we now tell you that for perpendicularity, there is a concept. If we have two lines and these two lines were perpendicular, then it means that the slope of one of the line is equal to 1 all over the slope of the second line. So for perpendicularity, the slope or the gradient of the line M2, which is the second line, is equal to 1 all over the gradient of the first line. We are looking for the gradient of the second line. Now we have been able to get the gradient or the slope of the first line. So we are going to use this formula, M2 equals to 1 over M1, to actually get the slope. Okay, so from here, this implies that, of course, you know M1 is the gradient of the first line, right? Then M2 is what we are looking for, the gradient of the second line. So it implies that M2 is equals to 1 all over the slope of the first line, which is minus 3 over 2. When you do your mathematical manipulations, of course, according to the law of indices, these two will now go up and this three remains down. So we now have this to be equals to minus 2 over 3. So when you look at the options, you can see clearly that the answer is B. So we bring back the options to you so you could see clearly. Okay, we have come to the end.